So, hello everyone, it's time to watch for Realist Hero, you know, with realistic mathematical solution or something, episode 4, baby, of 現実主義 勇者 の王国 再建記, yeah, 勇者, your hero, right? Anyway, let's watch the video, this is 3, 2, 1, and go, I'll give you my little recap on it from the last episode in the opening. Turn it off and... Maybe I'm deaf in one ear. Now I'm like, why is the only sound in one ear? Maybe I'm deaf right there. that's not good. So last time, of course, he picked out his party members. You kind of got the fat guy, likes to eat. Got the cute wolf girl. Apparently it was a girl, I thought it was a boy first. So, yeah, anime. I was like, I thought it was a boy, but it was a girl. It's anime, after all. And the singer girl. Mermaid, clearly. Mermaid family things. I don't understand how... what she's useful for. She can sing, I guess. Morale or something. And then you got the... you know, the hot dark elf, yeah. Which obviously, she's the, you know, muscle. She's the muscle of the team, of course. The classic, the tank, right? Of the party. The most obvious... I mean, she's the fighter. She's the most obvious useful guy. The team. Yeah, and they got these different monsters, and they got dragons and so on. Okay, so dragons are better. And slimes are good people. Okay, slimes are like animals, yeah, okay, they're like, you know, Rimarus. There's like a manticore, cockatrice. That is like a gargoyle, but it looks like the... not Firebrand, but the bad guy in Firebrand's game, Demon Crest. But yeah, we're here against his team. Of course, the waifu refused the first bow, then he mentioned one thing about trees, and then he... yeah. This is the wolf girl can talk to animals, so I guess like slime or someone. But here we go, opening, baby, opening! But I mean, we saw the party members in the opening, so we kind of knew he was going to pick them up anyway. And obviously the singer is a daughter, right, of the other woman, the Arara woman, clearly. She's the, like the lady of the lake, right, kind of power of water, right, and she got the kind of mermaid singing power, so yeah, that's like straight up there, right. Like she's probably posh mermaid something, like her grandpa has like a merman or something. This is her mom, clearly, in the opening, right. I mean, obviously, yeah, obviously, right. Man. Maybe I hit my head or something. I have a hard time hearing in one ear. It's weird. Yeah, and you got the poltergeist power. Lisha! The sassy waifu! And then you got this other waifu, the singing waifu, Yuna, yeah, the oppais. Then you got the fighter waifu. I mean, I like how they get the waifus in order here, yeah. And then you got the brain husband, though, but yeah. And then you got the fat guy and the brain guy. And then you got the little wolf girl. Toboe. Like the other anime. With the dragon waifu. Yeah, I'm not a Tomoe waifu. But Tomoe as a name is always unique for me, right? The evil woman Tomoe. Yeah, it's always like an evil name, so... But here we go. Anime. Isekais. And etc. What will happen, baby? Okay, so wolf girl can clearly talk to animals. We understand that. She's clearly had power, seems to be the best by far. Like the other one, like a fast guy, seems to be very effective. But her powers are clearly like super OP, right? But how did she get here? Did she turn to anyone else? These are very clear plot holes in anime. It's like a huge plot holes in anime. Like, so she could talk to animals, but I guess she told him this the first. Like, only my mom knows. How did she get to this selection then, right? Yeah. Or the request? I don't know. What, you know what I mean? It's a kind of weird thing. Like, what does she? Yeah, I don't know. I really dislike, of course, as last episode, how they, you know, yeah, I really dislike, right, how he didn't pick them out. He didn't talent show them. They just came to his place, right? I really dislike that, yeah. He just get them for free. Like, it's a really bad way to show his intelligence to the main character. That he just got them, they just arrived at his place, right? Yeah, that was a really stupid way to do it. Not a big fan of that whatsoever. Yeah, so what's she telling them? What's she whispering? What's the secrets? Gemstone broadcast. Yeah, what did she say? And she can control them, I guess. She can also probably control them. That she's a beast tamer, I guess. Demons too. They are demons then? Yeah, I mean, they're winning against humans, right? They have to be smarter than humans. They'll be stronger at least. But I feel this anime is so weird with the plot holes, because kind of like, you know, how did she get through the first exams, you know, the first talent that we didn't see, without telling them she could speak to demons, you know what I mean? Like, how did she not tell that? I mean, I guess it was enough to talk to monsters or something. That way it feels so weird. Yeah, like she can like, she didn't tell them a secret up there. You know, why wouldn't she tell them before, right? You know what I mean? It's so plot holy that the whole how the talent stuff worked out. There was a short demon, like a shibby one? The cute demon girl? It's like a kobold man. Yeah, the demons look like monsters to me. I don't know how they're demons. Demons to me, you know, is a guy with horns, right? Yeah, they look like kobolds. They look like a typical monster man. The same scent, she smells like demons. Is she maybe part demon? Because she looks like, she's a freaking fox girl. There was a kobold. They seem to be kind of similar, right? So I don't know how, what makes, you know, the mystic wolf not be a demon if a demon is like kobold, it's also like a dog animal. Yeah, I don't know how this world really works here. I don't understand that build up really. They do this weird 3D flex thing which we did earlier too. We had this weird angular thing which they kind of throw in again there. Huh. The second time we did that. Well, obviously they are demons, that's like, they were the enemies, I mean, it's like, they are seen as enemies, but yeah, because they conquered half the country or something, so, they, like, wouldn't it be enemies anyway, even if you talk to them? It's a little bit like, a weird way, I think, to present that. They are enemies because you can't talk to them. No, they're enemies because they attacked you and took over your land. I feel that's like, even if you could understand them, wouldn't you be like, they're killing me, and I understand killing me, like... Yeah, goddess, those demons. But yeah, little Tome got a demon tongue. And she's all like, Onishan, let's be friends! She's seducing the sassy one here. Yeah, using a little charm, the kawaii powers. Yeah, that, she got both the demonic tongue and she's a kawaii girl, so, you know. She's like double valuable in that. I guess they probably will lynch her, some kind of a demon talker girl, you know. Yeah, you can talk to those demons, girl. I don't know if it's that important, honestly. It depends on what you can do with that. Because if demons are really evil, and they're like, just kill them all anyway, if demons are like, we don't negotiate with humans, right, they wouldn't help much, right? So I don't know how important that is. And if the demons are intelligent enough to speak to you, they can learn your language, or vice versa. Because a language is a language. If they can speak and use weapons and so on, obviously someone can eventually syntax the language. Like, that's just how language works, so... You can obviously learn how they're speaking, right? Eventually. Hmm. Man, the burn. Poor princess. Ooh, secondary concert. You can smash her. He's like, why don't you smash her? Very good. Yeah, he's making you your wife. This guy is thinking. He's like, make you a harem wife. Pick up the Aisha too. Pick up the other wives too. And pick up the Yuna Gun. She's 10. He's allowed in the range. Man, what is this guy? That is aligned. Let's do it. Yeah, why are you putting it at me? Is this guy perv? Yeah, why is she like, you perv? This man, Mark's guy is clearly the perv. He's like, oh, 10 years old. How proper. Yeah, she's my immortal now. Good, I picked her up as an immortal. Nice, yeah, we make her my immortal. I have a family. Like, she's like, weirdos. Like, she's like, no, I have my mom and my brother, you weirdos. Like, she's like, leave me alone, crazy pervs. Yeah, like, she's like, defending yourself. No, get away from me, people. Yeah. Okay, so he's adopting a little kawaii wolf girl. Why not? Who wouldn't do that? But I like her, she's like, don't touch me, weirdo. Yeah. She immediately was like, wait, you preach, that's kind of weird. Yeah, I don't want this. You're too touchy. Very good, girl, very good. I agree with her. That was weird. What a weirdo. She could be the, I don't know, around the stables. Yeah, I knew it. She horses, yeah. She ran the stable, right? Of course. She can run the stables. Classic wolf girl. You can be in the stables, in the hay. But yeah, this Mars guy is a weirdo. He's like, you can marry her. Make her your wife. Yeah. It's like, well, yes, she's a little too young for that. Maybe like, oh, it's perfect. She's in the age. So that guy's a weirdo. Oh, he's like tailoring? It's like a ninja thing in the opening. I guess he's gonna poltergeist that. I understand you're suing. Why are you doing it in front of me in my room? It's like, why are you suing here for? Yeah, this is so annoying. I said, I avoid them. And I guess his magic still works if he's not there. Yeah, like some kind of flow thing over there. So this doll is like a ninja doll in the opening, I guess I can control it with its power, I guess. Yeah, what are you in my room for? But I'm your husband though, yeah, we're married, right? Yeah, like, come on. And I guess she's a little, and the king takes the cue too. Yeah. Yeah, she's really is adopted now. Yeah, so I guess she goes a mom too now, yeah, I guess she's adopted now. There's a maid that looks kind of hot, never seen before, interesting. And then the screen froze. What's the maid? Like, woo-hoo-hoo! See? This you're doing it now! See, the maid, if you have say, yeah, well, yeah, okay, the maid's like, oh, I see! Ooh, the king! That was weird. Then he grabs her arm, though, so yeah, how's the maid not gonna read into this thing? Well, I mean, they are a fiancé after all, so... Yeah, so, okay, so fat guy is back. He's fat. You know, it's like Kevin James. Yeah, he's like, he's fat guy. He's fat guy. Oh, he has a royal viewer he can fly on? What? Yeah, so what, they have like a flying viewer? A dragon knight thing going on here? We haven't seen that in anime. Holy shit, man. He got a magic exception. It is straight up like a JRPG. He got the magic item box. You can put in how much you want in it. Yeah, it's one of those, you know, heroic magic stuff. You can put in items in. Yeah, you can. Yeah, you can use a lot of items in it. It's like an item box thing. Magic satchel. Okay, yeah. Why not? Why not, baby? Why not? Of course. Yeah, magic satchel. Right. Makes sense. Ha. Huh? Yeah. Why wouldn't he have a magic satchel for? They're a magical kingdom, right? I guess she's like the, I don't know, she's the radio host or something. I guess that's what she is. She's like the, yeah, she's turned into the popular girl running. Yeah, she's the host, Yuna Doma. She's running like the popularity thing. She's like, and Panna Cotta, what his name is, yeah. Panna Cotta, fat guy, he likes Panna Cottas. And there's a warrior lady, Aisha, she's just something, I guess. She's a warrior. Yeah, but she's the front figure of the empire now. Yeah, ooh, she works too? Hot, yeah, she's like, come to my hot maid coffee, yeah. So she's really selling herself here, she's really like... There's a kind of weird comedy joke now. Stop endorsing yourself, you woman, yeah! So finally, the king here comes here. Is it the king yet? Did the king give up though? Oh, he's active king. He's like, I'm king only in name, yeah, and in power, and basically also got the princess, so I'm the king. But anyway. Yeah, so we're finally dropping the cotton farms. He's gonna apologize to the poor people for having a previously bad king there. I guess we're gonna, yeah, remove the cotton, right? Okay, what are you gonna do then? Okay, I guess fat guy is gonna show them how to eat mushrooms. He's gonna be like, hey, so you can find some stuff on the ground. He's like, yeah, bugs? I guess, right, I guess this is the fat guy's job here, to show them weird food stuff he's found on the ground or something. Wait, we have food tasters here? This sounds kind of tricky to tell me about this thing. Yeah, they're like, what are we here for? And also, why are they gonna food taste? Wouldn't he just be knowing the good stuff? And all the girls are like, no, hentai! Yeah! Why do you have an octopus for? But see, I don't know what a fat guy isn't just doing this thing. Why hasn't he done this? I think this anime has some plot holes, generally, because like, wouldn't he already have decided what is a good food for them? Isn't that his job? Isn't Yuna... But like, well, she's from a water girl, she's a mermaid, so... And also, why is the king preparing it for, not the fat guy for? Yeah, it feels weird to me. Like, why hasn't the fat guy done this already? And there's like a very slow scene when he... I mean, his name is SOUMA, so we've been saying that he's a simp king of the chefs, right? Yeah. SOUMA comes to you, he's a simp and a chef. So yeah, he's... SOUMA is cooking. I mean, it makes sense, you know. Course, all the girls are gonna, you know, go like, oh my, yeah, lose their clothes when they, yeah, Aisha's gonna go all, you know, lose their clothes when he gives them their octopus here, of course, a taco. Obviously, these girls are gonna lose their clothes now, we're gonna eat the food. Even Tomoe is gonna explode, right? Yeah, she's gonna go, oh my, give me a SOUMA scene. He's called SOUMA, let him be a SOUMA scene there. Nah, come on, it's pathetic. It's just delicious, oh my god, man. He's even called SOUMA. This is the best thing he can do. But honestly though, it doesn't make any sense to me that he's like cooking for the whole city, right? Or the country. Why isn't the fat guy already judged this thing? What is the fat guy's point then? If he just finds the ingredient, he hasn't even cooked, you know. Isn't his job to tell them that octopus is tasty? Like, why do they have the fat guy for? Yeah, and people are like, wow, yeah, we can eat octopus. This is so unrealistic, honestly. This anime is quite stupid, isn't it? Because if people really have a story, if people really were starving, they would obviously eat this thing without having to teach that, right? They would eat it anyway. Yeah, if people really were starving, if it's like a starvation in a country, and the guy's like, we caught a lot of octopus yesterday, they would eat that. They wouldn't be like, oh, we can eat those animals we caught yesterday. Yeah, they would eat it, right? Yeah, it's really stupid. Of course, she has the wood girl. Yeah, she's like, you eat everything, I'm a wood girl, yeah, so of course. Again, you know, why does he have to teach them? Oh, look at him, he's like, oh, I'm gonna do a SOUMA salting here. He's like, I'm channeling my inner SOUMA, throwing some salt in it. Again, why is he the chef for? Why isn't it the fat guy the chef for? And now it's like tasty crisps or something. Yeah, salty flavor, tree root or something. Yeah, I mean, but again... She already knows this, she's from the freaking, you know, wood people. What do they already know? Why does he have to tell the people in the country to eat wood or something? Obviously, she already knows that. Yeah. She wants more, of course. And yeah, like, Aisha seems to be fat now. Yeah. Okay, fine, something he already prepared, at least. Fine, something the fat yet prepared. Oh yeah, no, this is the fat yet coming in here. Cockroaches, here we go. I totally got earlier, bugs, right? Here we go, now it's anime. Of course, Tom is like, oh, I love this shit. Oh man, yeah, I eat all the time at home, yeah! Yes, I season with water and sugar, baby! Yeah, use that, you know, Mystic Wolf water, that is awesome. Bead Mosh water. Yeah, okay. Then cockroaches or locust gets really tasty. Yeah, it makes the insects really get tasty, right? Yeah, you ferment it and it becomes this weird moss water. Very unique flavors, yeah, very unique. Perfect for cockroaches. Yeah, it's very Japanese, it's very Japanese. Fermented food, yeah, it's miso, it's very Japanese, it's fermented. It's like, he's like, oh my god! He's like, it's natto! He's like, natto! Oh my god, it tastes like natto, right? He's gonna be like, oh, it tastes like natto! I think he feels the soya, the miso, the natto. He's like, it's like a natto! It tastes exactly like Japan! This, yeah, it tastes of my Japanese! This clearly tastes like, he's like the natto, right? Come on. It's miso soy sauce, but I feel it's gonna be, if it was a butcher, he'd be like, natto! Because I heard fermented, I'm like, oh my god, it's natto! Yeah, it's very Japanese, it's a fermented soy. He's so moved, he's like, my king, what are you doing? He's like, I'm crying, it's so good! Yeah, taste of Japan, man. Is he prepared before with this? What is now then? Animals, demons. Cliffhanger? What can be the cliffhanger for food? Like, I honestly, I'm a little impressed. They were like, let's cliffhanger this, baby! This is some kind of super exciting food! The demon thing felt like a pretty good cliffhanger, but now I was like, food? What can it be? He already showed octopus and cockroaches. But I do find it kind of stupid, yeah. I feel the anime has a lot of, like, you know, it's like a major plot holes, but it's a lot of, like, tiny plot holes, I feel, in the anime. Because it's like, you know, if people were starving, it's like a famine, right? You would eat the octopus. Like, it doesn't make any sense. You know that lobster used to be kind of like the poor man's food, right? Lobster was like, it's for idiots. I don't eat that. It's for the peasants, right? Because, yeah, lobster is easy to catch, especially in America, like in Maine and so on, like in East America, East Coast America earlier. And then they got overfished, right? And then it turned into a delicacy because there were so few of them left. So basically, the poor people eat a lot of lobster, right? Because it's easy to catch them back in the days, right? And they didn't care, right, if the lobster was some kind of insect from the sea, right? So, like, it doesn't make much sense, honestly, that this kid is like, Dad, we have 10 octopus, Dad. Can we eat those? And they thought, like, wow, yeah, boy, we got food over there, woo, you know. Like, why wouldn't they just eat it before? Like, the fisher people would, of course, eat what the fish, if it's a starvation, right? You would eat that, or at least sell it, right, to the people, yeah. And same with the tree stuff and so on. So, this whole premise doesn't make much sense until they shot the cockroach, but at the same time, the wood people already eat that, so it's not really, it's like a hit. He hasn't really discovered anything new, like he's just showing them stuff that people are already eating, right? So yeah, I think that scene was really stupid. Like, that scene was, it's a weird anime in that sense, because it really is like, yeah, it has a lot of like minor plot holes. There's a lot of like convenience in the plot that doesn't really, you know, make sense, right? And also, of course, why is he cooking them? Why isn't the fat guy, why isn't panna cotta already, you know, prepare them? Yeah, and now it's like, yeah, this man's like, yeah, I usually toss them away, but let's eat them now. You know what I mean? That doesn't make any sense. Then it can't be like a food shortage if they're throwing away food, right? Like, that would never happen in reality. It really wouldn't. Like, I've never been in a country in the world where you can capture octopus and you don't eat them, right? Like, not saying that it's the most highest delicacy ever, but when I was in Greek, you know, when I was in Cyprus, I've been in Greek, I've been in Turkey, so on, like, They eat octopus, right, in these different, you know, Mediterranean islands, because you catch octopus, right? Which octopus is my hometown for that matter too, but in my hometown it's a lot of lobster and eel, right? Yeah, in my hometown it's very eel, it's very Christmassy. Lobster, we make this called hummertino, or hummertino, yeah, you make this lobster traps, right, in school, and you capture them, and we catch a lot of lobster at my father's marina, so one, yeah, the Navy base for my father, and I work, so on. He owns a place that, yeah, we have a lot of lobster traps, they're always in the fall, and so on. So, like, if you have an animal you can capture, right, people have eaten it, right, yeah. So they're gonna have like a food shortage, a famine thing going on to some extent, and also not just eating animals to capture, right? This is really stupid. Like, that's not how people actually act. So this anime has something sort of issue. The thing is, like, here is a smarty pantsy main character with solutions to problem the people are ready to fix, right? Because if people are hungry enough, they're gonna eat dogs, you know what I mean? They eat an octopus, something people have eaten in every country basically that has an ocean, right? That has, given that they have octopus in the ocean. But yeah. You can't find a country in the world, I think, where you can capture anything in the ocean, like a fish, right, or a whale, or a dolphin, whatever, and you don't eat it. Obviously, today, we kind of, you know, the whale is, yeah, it's very like, oh, whale and dolphin and so on, right, they're kind of intelligent, something like that. But, I mean, traditionally speaking, right, medieval times, find a medieval country on planet Earth where they had, like, a dolphin captured and they didn't try to eat it. Like, that doesn't make any sense. Of course you did, right? So octopus, same thing. People try to eat them. So it's really weird. I mean, the episode is fine, but it has a lot of those, like, minor plot holes. A lot of those minor inconvenient plot holes that makes the whole premise, I think, kind of hard to special disbelief. Yeah, it's like a lot of stuff like, well, not people really didn't do it. Same thing with the wood thing. Like, obviously, Aisha already eats. He likes though. Yeah, the elves already eats them. So who is he telling to eat that? Because these roots are from the elf country, right? Where people already live, the elves, the dark elves already live there. So he's telling the dark elves that already eats them to eat them? You know what I mean? Like, it's a kind of, yeah, it's a very redundancy. It's a really weird anime. I feel it's a decent anime, but it's so many minor issues. And also, the demon looks like a kobold or something. So what's the difference, really? I mean, I know they explained it earlier, but the explanation to me wasn't good enough, honestly. Yeah, they explained it, but it wasn't good enough, in my opinion, to really, truly distinguish between a demon and like a beast person, right? But anyway, that's review. That's the episode. I guess it took a half an hour from now.